Hi there. I think most harp players would agree that that's one of the most fun things you can do on the harmonica, and probably one of the kind of sounds that attracts a lot of people to the harp is this kind of like funky bottom end, you know, rhythm stuff. And it's because of the tuning of the Richter harmonica. You know, you've got the blow chord and the draw chord. And between the two of them, you can just do so much great stuff, you know, sort of straight ahead or syncopated or sort of swung. So there's just, you know, there's just an infinite number of ways you can vary it, play around with it. But I suppose there's a couple of important characteristics in all that sort of rhythm vamping. It's a mixture of chords, full chords, and also some single note runs. So I've got a kind of a little clean little run in the middle of the chord. Okay, and there's a lot of bounce in the chords as well, and you sort of, I'm getting that through, you know, just making my mouth a little bit wider or narrower as I go. So what I was wondering was, can I get that kind of feeling, that kind of bounce, that kind of groove, can I emulate it on a MIDI harmonica? The one I've chosen is the Lekholm DM48, and the reason for that is that it has a polyphonic mode. So monophonic mode just gives you single notes, and that's what I use most of the time. But recently I've been exploring polyphonic mode, and this is where you can get huge chords or small chords or whatever. And again, it's controlled by your mouth, what you do in the mouth. So that's the theory, but does it sound any good? So you be the judge. So I'm going to start off with a sound as close as I can get to the, you know, acoustic harmonica. So I've got an app open here called Thumb Jam, and this is actually an accordion sound, but it sounds pretty close to a harp. So I hope you can hear there that I'm actually getting a similar kind of thing. So I can get single notes. Well, I can emulate the blues harp bends, you know, so with this little gizmo here, which, it came out originally as the mini pitch bender, but it's now been upgraded and given all sorts of new powers by Professor John Shirley in America, who's my new partner with it. And we call it the miniMIDI joystick, miniMIDI joystick. In this case, I'm just using it for bends, but it's got a whole lot of other stuff it can do, which, that's another story. So it can go semitone bends. So that's like your four draw. And also, if I wanted to get this three draw bend. Okay, so that's the accordion sound. Let's try and find some other sounds. This one's called blues organ. I'm now in an app called Thor, and I've got a patch here called Clarinet Wah. So this is this sort of sound. But I can add in, I've got a little octava here, so I can add in a bit of that if I want. They've got an accordion sound as well. Nothing special, but just add in some bottom end. What else? This is supposedly cello. So here's another kind of wah sort of sound. Add some bottom end. So you can hear I'm kind of getting that kind of bounce, you know, that you get on the harp. You can get that sort of blow chords. Kind of similar to what you get on the harp. That kind of thing. So let's find some other sounds. Okay, I'm in a new app now. This is called Korg M1. It's got lots of sounds, many of them based on the old M1 keyboard. Now this one's called Shakuhachi. Okay, here's something called Anna Brass. Okay, let's try some other brass sounds. This one's called muted brass. This one's quite nice, it's called Thailand, kind of a synthy sort of flute sound. So far I've been using standard MIDI outputs where basically all the chord notes are the same volume, but sometimes when you're playing the harp, you know, you've got your lips are centered around one hole, and then there's kind of a shading where the holes on either side are not quite as loud. So if I blow hole number two, and then I've got number one and number three. But probably number two, the one I started with, is probably marginally louder. Well, there's a new kind of expression now called MIDI polyphonic expression, or MPE. And MPE aims to give you that kind of shading. So I've got an app here called Roly Seaboard, and you can actually see on the screen the notes that I'm playing. So I'm in Richter tuning, and if I play, two blow, and then bring in the one blow and the three blow, you can hear the two blow stays louder, And the one and the three come in, but they're a little bit quieter. So it kind of gives that more naturalistic... You can probably hear slightly that there's a slightly more subtle feeling with that, a slightly more shaded feeling. This is another app that's MPE enabled. It's called Shoom. And if I play, you'll probably see the little circles. There's one, you know, bigger than the other two. So just to give that, shows it shading. Okay, well, this has just been a little demo, a little exploration through the idea of kind of getting a bouncy kind of chordal kind of rhythm using a MIDI harmonica. I've just used one rhythm feel and illustrated it with various different sounds on the amazing DM48. So the main thing is just getting across that you can actually play single notes or chords, just like on a harp. I'm really enjoying this new little exploration because it's making the MIDI harmonica just feel more kind of more like a real one to me, a bit more sort of natural than human, I suppose. Though I do also love the monophonic sound as well. Bye for now.